This video is dedicated to all the women out there who are late and ready to know the truth. Whether it was planned or not, the only way to know before the old-fashioned way, is by using a take-home chemistry kit that you all know as a pregnancy test. But how does a little strip of paper and a few drops of urine tell you whether or not you've got a bun in the oven? Well, let's find out. When a person becomes pregnant, hormones start sending chemical signals to prep the body for the tiny person who will be taking up a 9-month residency inside. One of the first hormones produced is human chorionic gonadotropin, or HCG for short. And this is what pregnancy sticks are designed to detect. Pregnancy tests have three sections: the place to pee on, the place where the main chemistry happens, and a control to make sure you can be confident in the results. There's some pretty tricky chemistry that goes on during the test. So what we're gonna do is show you both a positive test and a negative test side by side for comparison. After pee is applied to the first part of the test stick, capillary action causes it to slowly flow through to the other end. First, it passes through a thin strip loaded with mobile antibodies that are taken up by the pee and are designed to bind to the HCG. These antibodies are also equipped with a special piece of cargo that's put to use later on in the test, but we'll come back to that later. If HCG is present, like in test 1, the antibodies start binding to it and move through the test as a unit, unlike in test 2, where the antibodies move through on their own. At this point, you can't actually see anything happening, but that's about to change as the pee flows to the next section, which we here at Reactions like to call the antibody test forest. Each individual tree in the tree forest is an antibody rooted in place that's specifically designed to grab onto a different part of the HCG. So when the pee in test 1 passes through, the HCG antibody pairs get trapped in the branches of the tree forest, where that extra piece of cargo comes into play. And as more and more HCG antibody pairs get stuck in the forest and begin building up, that dye becomes more and more visible to the naked eye. And that's the blue line you see if you're pregnant. The urine in test 2, on the other hand, with solo mobile antibodies in it, flows right through the tree forest undetected. But that leaves test 2 a bit high and dry, don't you think? How can they be sure that, say, their test strip wasn't ripped, cutting off the urine from reaching the antibody forest, or that the mobile antibodies were really taken up by the pee? For this reason, manufacturers added a control, another antibody forest downstream from the first one that we'll call the control forest. The control forest is exactly like the test forest, except instead of having antibodies designed to detect HCG, they're actually designed to detect the mobile antibodies. So in both test 1 and test 2, the branches of the control forest grab onto the mobile antibodies. As they build up, the dye in the special cargo becomes visible and the control line appears. All functional pregnancy tests should have this control line appear. If it doesn't, it means something messed up the test result and you'll have to try again. If both lines light up, there's over a 99% chance that you're pregnant. If you think you're pregnant, but the test is negative, wait a few days and try again. We here at Reactions want to wish a happy Mother's Day to all those incredible mothers out there who got the blue line and brought us into this wonderful chemistry-filled world. We want to see some love for moms down below, people. Don't be shy. Thanks for watching.